the direction that Russell has led us is just God was in it. Bwana asifiwe. I was praying, and every time I pray that every time we come here in this church, we want to be led by the Spirit of God. And indeed, the Spirit of God was in that. We are supposed to break the vows. There are people who are vowed to bring us down. They are children of the devil. They are always vowing to destroy. They are very much committed in their service to the devil. They work even in our midst. Bwana asifiwe. They are friendly witches. They are the brood of vipers. And they are very cold-hearted. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana roho baridi. They come near you. They see you suffering. They sympathize with you. But when they go away, they laugh in their heart. They are always planning evil. And I'm telling you, even what is happening in this ministry, you know very well, we are being fought. I didn't know how this service was going to end, to go. But I thank God because of Brother Basil. Bwana asifiwe. Si akili zake zimesema, si akili zake zimepeana huo mwongozo. That is the battle we are going to fight today. To break the vows of people who have vowed to make sure that we do not rise. Kuna watu ambao wanasema tu akiinuka anaumwa. Bwana asifiwe. Akiona una amani anaumwa. Akiona tu umetulia unataka kuishi maisha yako, anaumwa sana. Anasema kwa nini Toba amenyamaza hivyo? Atusikia kibeg beg. Kwa nini? Na kule wangu anasema anajifanya. Tutaona, we are giving him time. Bwana asifiwe. Akisikia prophecy imetokea pale anasema kwa nini? Who is that? And these people are agents of the devil. They are demons living in them. They have become vehicles for the devil. The demons cannot work without a body. They are always looking for a body to work in. Bwana asifiwe. And these people are stationed everywhere. The devil is very clever. He stationed them everywhere in ministries next to servants of God, watching for an opportunity just to make sure that they fall and they slay that bitch. Ndio waende kuinua hiyo makosa wa nasambaza kama what they say they are saved. Bwana asifiwe. They are even targeting our children. They want them to go and sin. They are releasing arrows of rebellion so that our children can rebel. They are claiming the names of our children. These people have become an airport for the demons. And we want to show them that our God is mighty. Bwana asifiwe. Nani, kitabu ambacho ambacho basi amesoma amezungumza kuhusu Paulo. Aliitwa na Mungu akasema lazima utahubiri. Bwana asifiwe. Kule alikuwa amemtuma ni kwamba kulikuwa na watu wake kule. Kuna kazi, kuna majukumu ambayo Mungu alikuwa amempatia Paulo. Na akamwambia you will go. You must go. Bwana asifiwe. Lakini kuna watu wengine walijua na chuki. Walichukizwa kwa sababu alikuwa na uhubiri na akawinu watu wengi sana. Wengine wakaingiwa na wivu na wengine walikuwa wamesoma Torati. Wanajua sheria ya Mungu, wanajua ukweli. Lakini kwa sababu gani Paul? Why Paul? Who is he? Bwana asifiwe. And they vowed. Walienda katikati ya makundi wakachochea. Bwana asifiwe. Wakachochea. There are people who had listened to Paul and now they were envious. When you are preaching, when you are praying, there are people who are jealous. They have the devil in them. Unless you stand firm, utaanguka tu. These people are strong. Wakwepo hawezi bila nguvu za Mungu. Bwana asifiwe. Wana machini ndani mwao, wana mapepo yanakaa ndani mwao. They are agents of the vehicles of the devil. You can't defeat them. You need God. That place Paul alipitia, mahali pale Daudi alifika. Bwana asifiwe. Na akasema, ukisoma Zaburi 138 verse 3, anasema in the day when I cried out, you answered me and made me bold with strength in my soul. Wakati ambapo nikulilia, ulinipa nguvu. Bwana asifiwe. It is only God who can give you strength in such situation. Ukifunguliwa macho uone, utaogopa. Bwana asifiwe. There is a time also, David, I want us to read through Psalms verse 9, chapter 9, chapter 18. And we want us to see, I want us just to see how God is mighty, how he is powerful. And with that knowledge, ambia Mungu afafanue nguvu za Mungu. Vile Daudi, alisifu Mungu kulingana na mambo haya. Na alipo mtukuza Mungu, sisi utakapoona vile Mungu alipigana mahali pale. Nataka tuombe in line with what we understand about how God can fight. Bwana asifiwe. Let us just read. Listen carefully. Read it and you see how mighty he is. How mighty is, but he never loses battle. Hashindwi vitani. Bwana asifiwe. Utakapoona nguvu zake, pray. Increase your faith as you read this. Bwana asifiwe. I will, in the chapter 18 Psalms, I will love you, O Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock and my fortress, my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. David is praising the Lord. He is speaking about his faith. The reason why he is mentioning God as his rock and his fortress, his deliverer, that is where his faith is. He knows God delivers. He is the rock. He cannot just be moving. Asukumwe tu, asongwe na maneno. Yeye ni nguvu zangu. Imani yake ya doubt. Iko hivyo ndani ya Mungu. As you read verse 2, place your faith there if that is what you believe. The Lord is my rock and my fortress, my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Yeye ni ngome yangu. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. He is the only one we can call upon. Because when we call upon him, we are saved from our enemies. That is a faith, very strong faith, anchored in God himself. The banks of death surrounded me, and the floods of ungodliness made me afraid. Alifika mahali aliogopa, aliona tu kifo, alitetemeka. The sorrows of Sheol surrounded me. The snares of death confronted me. Mitego ambayo tu ilimwandama ilikuwa ya kifo. Akiangalia kushoto ni kifo. Tisha ambalo lilitoka, gurumo zilikuwa zinatisha na kutingiza moyo wake. I'm telling you, without God you cannot make it. It is fearful. Inatisha kusema kweli. If there is an agent of the devil next to you, if you are aware that the devil is hunting for you, I'm telling you, you have a reason to fear. But and that fear should lead you to God. Bwana asifiwe. Hii kitu inatetemesha, usione ni mchezo. And that is what is giving those enemies courage. They know they have power. They have marine spirits. They have forces in them. They know they cannot do anything. Them, they are just vehicles of the devil. They have vowed to make sure that this ministry cannot expand. Bwana asifiwe. It is terrible. David's eyes were open and he saw it. He experienced it in the body. In my distress, he says, I called upon the Lord and cried out to my God. He heard my voice from his temple, and my cry came before him, even to his ears. This cry, when he cried with that faith he had in God, though he saw what was happening, though the enemies had surrounded him, hell was confronting him, death, snares of hell, always surrounded him. He cried in that distress. He did not just keep quiet and cry to seek sympathy from people. He did not join the enemy to find peace. He cried to God, when as he knew it. And the God from his temple heard his prayers, when as he knew it. He came for him, and even to his ear, the cry that he cried to God reached the ears of God. The Bible says he is not deaf. His ears are not too heavy that he cannot hear. Bwana asifiwe. And he said, then the earth shook. When God heard the cry of David, the earth shook and trembled. The foundations of the hills also quaked and were shaken because he was angry. When God heard, he became angry. He had not acted yet. He was just angry. And this is what happened. And verse 8, it says, smoke went up from his nostrils, and devouring fire from his mouth, coals were kindled by it. That is how God reacted when David cried to God. Are you picturing that in your mind? Are you picturing how God is? How powerful, how mighty he is? At the hearing of your voice, he just had David. When he had David, the Bible says in verse 7, the earth shook and trembled. When as if you will. The earth realized that God is angry. It shook and trembled. And the foundations of the hills also quaked and were shaken because he was angry. He was just angry. He had not acted. Verse 8, smoke went up from his nostrils. and devouring fire from his mouth, cause were kindled by it. Bwana asifiwe. Number 9, he bowed the heavens also and came down with darkness under his feet. Bwana asifiwe. He was just coming. He was not yet there. He had heard the cry of David. This is what David saw. He saw how God came to fight for him, how he was angry. This is how much God loves us. See, this is how much he's concerned about us. He gets angry, and when he gets angry because of our destroyers, this is what happens. The earth quakes, it trembles before him. The heavens are bowed before us, if you will, and there is darkness below his feet, one as if he will. And he rode upon the cherub, verse 9. And flew. He flew upon the wings of the wind. He made darkness his secret place. The canopy around him was dark waters and thick clouds of the skies. From the brightness before him, his thick clouds passed with hailstones and coals of fire. Bwana asifiwe. Mvua inanyesha, mbona mvua ya mawe vile inacheza nyumbani, inanyesha nyumbani. Lakini wakati Mungu amekasirika, ati mvua ya mawe inanyesha, na pia makaa ya moto inanyesha. Tunajua kwa kawaida ya kwamba moto uzima, uzimwa na maji. But in this case, when God is fighting, he uses them both. Bwana asifiwe. Na yale mawe hayazimi moto, yanajua we are weapons in the hands of God. We are arrows in the hands of God. They cooperate and they fight together. Bwana asifiwe. Mawe ya barafu inaanguka, inapiga adui, inapasua madhabahu yao, inawatawanya, na mawe ya moto pia inaanguka. Bwana asifiwe. Ana hakuna ile nasema ingine kwa sababu they work in unity. That is how mighty our God is. When we go into these prayers, Bwana asifiwe, I want us to picture that and to see how our God is. Let us anchor our faith in this word, Bwana asifiwe, because it is life. And then today, this is our day that we want to see God shaking the heavens. We want to see mountains being shaken. We want to see the earth trembling. We want to see the heavens being bowed. We want to see him coming down. We want to hear him breathing fire. This is our day. If you believe with me, can you say this is our day?
This is our day.
This is our day.
This is our day.
Yes, we want to hear God. Verse 12. Skevla anasema. From the brightness before him, his thick clouds passed with hailstones and coals of fire. Verse 13. The Lord thundered from heaven, and the Most High uttered his voice, hailstones and coals of fire. That is what happens when he thunders from heaven. So when you pray and you are asking him to thunder, that is exactly what will happen. If truly you believe he hears your prayer, that alone shakes the earth, shakes the ground where you are. Bwana asifiwe. He sent out his arrows and scattered the foe. The foe is the enemy. He sent out his arrows and scattered the foe. The lightnings in abundance, and he vanquished them. Then the channels of the sea were seen. The foundations of the world were uncovered at your rebuke. Oh Lord, at the blast of your breath, of your nostril. Now God has spoken. His voice has thundered in the heavens. Daudi anasema ya kwamba, mikondo ya maji, ilifichuliwa, ilionekana. The foundations of the sea, even the foundations of the earth, were seen when he thundered from heaven. Right now you cannot see the foundation of the earth, but you know when he speaks now in his anger, when he thundered because his loved one has prayed, has cried to him, do you know what happens? They are seen. When as if you were, the seabed will be exposed. When as if you were, and the foundation of the earth will be exposed. When as if you were, you sababu dunia inatetemeka, amekasirika, tutaishia wapi? When as if you were, hakuna kitu kitafichika. Hata kama ni kifuli mtu alifunga na akasema ninakufunga ujuka, hautafaulu, na akatupa kwenye bahari, ikaenda mpaka pale chini. Mungu akikasirika, I'm telling you that thing will be exposed. There will be nothing hidden. Bwana asifiwe. God will reveal it. God will reach that place. He is God Almighty. He is the Creator. He will undo that padlock in the mighty name of Jesus. He will melt it. Hata ifungua tu, He will melt it, because when He opens His mouth, there is fire that comes out of His mouth. Bwana asifiwe. He sent from above. He shook. He took me. He drew me out of many waters. He saved David. He delivered me from my strong enemies, from those who hated me, for they were too strong for me. Telling you, these people were too strong for him. They are strong. Without him, you can't do anything. But when you know who God is, you will thank him like God. You will say, He is my deliverer. He is my rock of my salvation. That is when you realize the meaning of the Lord is my rock, of the rock of my salvation. Bwana asifiwe. Hapo ndipo utajua Bwana ni mahali pangu pa kujificha, pa kujificha. Mahali pa kujificha ni nani? Ni Mungu. That is when you will understand the meaning of those words. Bwana ni ngome yangu. The Lord is my stronghold. Bwana asifiwe. He also brought me into a broad place. He delivered me because He delighted in me. The Lord rewarded me according to my righteousness. According to the cleanness of my hands, He has recompensed me. For I have kept the ways of the Lord and have not wickedly departed from my God. For all His judgments were before me, and I did not put away His statutes from me. One has few. There is a secret also for this. We'll go before God, before you engage in this battle. If you are not clean, that evil will stand between you and this answer. When us view it, we want to repent. Anything that can stand between us and our God, His way is perfect. He is holy. When us view it, only when we are clean. Atuangalie naone kwamba ametupenda. He is delighted in us. I'm telling you, this is what will happen. When us view it, He's a man of war. He thunders. Smoke comes out of His nose, and there is fire from His mouth. Devouring fire. It will devour those evil shrines. Katika kitabu cha Isaiah, let me finish with that. Isaiah chapter 54. Then, go before God. Verse 15. Indeed, they shall surely assemble, but not because of me. Whoever assembles against you shall fall for your sake. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Watakusanyika, lakini sio Mungu amewatuma. Lakini Mungu anasema yote ambaye atainuka, atajikusanya tu kwa sababu yako to. Mungu anaenda kuanguka kwa sababu alikuinukia. Whoever has been fighting this ministry, he's going to fall.
Amen.
Because he rose against this ministry. Whoever has been handling weapons, whatever arrows against this ministry, the leadership of this ministry, holding them in their hand, saying they can take me nowhere. I have them in my hand, boasting in His witness, whatever they are doing. The Lord says, because of that, because of you, because they pointed finger at you, because they mocked you, because they mocked you, they vowed to bring you down. They are just here to make sure that you do not rise. I'm telling you, because they just confronted you, because they plant evil against you, they are going to fall. They are going to fall. One as if you were. Because they pointed at you, who God delights in, I'm telling you, they are going to fall. This is our day. Sema, this is our day.
This is our day.
This is our day.
This is
can
our
you
day.
Say it by faith? Sema, this is our day.
This is our
this
day.
This is my day.
This is my day.
This is my day.
This is my day. Amen.
I'll give a testimony of what happened to me. There is a time I almost died. I'm a child of God and I believe I cannot bow to idols. And I believe I'm not supposed to perform rituals because I don't even know them. I'm a child of the light, and therefore what I should follow is the judgments of God. And therefore when I went home, I didn't know I was crossing some boundaries. I just stayed there, not knowing that there were lines that are drawn that I'm not supposed to cross. And so, because of that, when I went, I traveled from where I got married and I went to my homeland where I was born. There is a demon that followed me. It was a principality, a demon. It was an ancestral power. It was claiming ground. It was saying you have done this and therefore you deserve to die. And I'm telling you, that day I was supposed to die. I cried. I'm telling you, I panicked. I tried to pray. I couldn't pray. When I was praying, it was like I was hitting a rock. Fortunately, I had some credit on my phone. I could call people. So I called my husband. I sent messages to people. I called them. I told them, pray for me. I'm trying to pray, but it is not working. I'm dying. These people prayed for me. My husband called people he knew also. They joined me to pray. And I'm told God was with me. When I see you, He arose from the highest heaven. He influenced these people by His Spirit. And these people prayed for me. They gave testimonies. They said that we prayed. They prayed. I still remember that day like yesterday. And I'm telling you, I was saved from that time. I was supposed to die. My mother told me my skin had changed. I was supposed to die that night. I saw the mortuary. The demon had gone there to knock at the door of the mortuary. I saw people waiting for me. The border popped up by his people and there was a pickup there. They were just waiting. Who will pick her? Who will pick her? When I see you. But I was delivered. Those who were banks of death, they were too strong for me. God delivered me. When I see you. David told Saul. When Saul told him, those people, that man is too strong. Goliath is too strong. He has been a warrior from his youth. David said, I was a young boy. I was taking care of my father's sheep. And the lion attacked me. And the lion and the bear. I was able to defeat them because God gave me strength. The God who delivered me from the mouth of the lion and the bear is the same God who delivered me from this Philistine. When I see you, he had anchored his faith in God. When I see you, you know where God has brought you from. You know that if it was not God, you wouldn't be where you are today. You know very well that there are so many places you have escaped death. I know this is just one I've mentioned. When I see you, the enemy has vowed to bring you down. He has vowed even through my friends just to make sure that grace will not go anywhere. Some people have even given money just to crush me, to disappoint me. But God, who brought me from those places, He gave me strength, who has enabled me to stand here to deliver this kind of message, He's the same God I'm worshiping. He will see us through. When I see you, He will see us through. When I see you, they will rise indeed. They shall surely assemble, but not because of me. Whoever assembles against you shall fall for your sake. Behold, I have created the blacksmith who blows the coals in the fire, who brings forth an instrument for his work, and I have created the spoiler to destroy. No weapon fashion against you shall prosper, and every tongue which rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is from me, says the Lord. When I see few, the righteousness we have is from God. When I see few, the work of the cross, the work of the cross. Colossians chapter 2, verse 15. Let us just finish with that. Colossians chapter 2. We will pray in line with the word of God. So let us just read Colossians chapter 2. Colossians chapter 2, verse 15.
Colossians 2 and 15. Uh-huh. It says, and having spoiled principalities and powers, He made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it.
He made a show of them openly, triumphing above them all. When I see you, that is the work of the cross. So our faith should point to the cross. with God comes from. That is where our victory originates. That is the foundation of our victory. Bwana asifiwe. Let us go before the Lord. Examine yourself. If there is anything that can stand between you and your prayer today, can you go before the Lord and repent that sin? Remove that obstacle. Break that wall, that barrier. Can you break it by faith? Repent the sins of your mind, your thoughts. Can you go before the Lord? Because this is our day. The Lord is going to fight against them that are bound in prayer. Because of you are accepting against this ministry. This is the day God is going to fight them dead in the mighty name of Jesus. God, I come before you. Father, not because I'm wondering, but because of your presence, I repent every sin. I repent every sin that is hiding in my heart, in my heart, and my spirit.
Whatever. Thank you.
pray against the evil priest. The evil priest that is being contacted in the heavens, that is hindering our prayers. He knows that through prayer we draw our strength from them. We want to bring down the principalities in the heavens that are starting to hinder us when we pray here. When we go home, we cannot pray again. We sleep. We become too heavy. We want to rest against those principalities. And you go before the Lord. Shoot arrows at me. Command them to die. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the 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 name of Jesus.
Thank you.
the devil. When you refuse to let go of the things of the devil, when you allow yourself to be used by the devil, you become the child of the devil. And you, child of God, who is here, you are the one I'm talking to. In the name of Jesus. The word of God says, when the children of God gather, the children of the devil also gather. We want to pray, God, to ignite His divine fire. Make it too hard for the children of the devil to stand this place. Make it too hard for the enemy to stand this place. Can you go for the Lord and ask Him to ignite the fire of the Lord God? Can you pray mightily? Let us go before the Lord. Oh Lord God Almighty, we are calling upon your name, O Jehovah. We pray, bring the fire in this place, O Lord. Thank you.
whatever you're great.
Kabla tujamaliza ningependa tuweze kutuma maombi.
Jesus.
Our sister Elena has been suffering and whatever is has been hurting her, it is demonic. I want us to go before the Lord and pray for her. As the church, the gates of hell cannot prevail over the church of the Lord. She is one of us. I want us to plead God's mercy upon her, to deliver her, to, that God may seal her with her with His protection.
Amen.
Let us go before the Lord and pray for Elena. He just mentioned.
Thank you.
maisha yao. Can you pray happily? Can you pray for me from your heart? Can you pray for the leadership of this ministry? For the elders? Pray for them. Baba, nashukuru kwa sababu ya uongozi wa kanisa hili. Whenever they have cared for them. Whenever they have cared for them. Let them not catch fire. Deliver them from the hand of the enemy. Deliver them from the hand of the enemy. Anoint them, O God. And manifest, O God, in their lives in the name of Jesus. Thank you for what you are doing. Thank you for what you are doing. Oh God, they are in your hands, O God. Anoint them and touch them. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
We bless your holy name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father. Thank you for what you've done, O God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for what you're going to do.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for what you've already started
doing.
We thank you for your presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for the Holy Spirit.
Thank you
because you are a mighty body. Father, you are driving out every of the demons hiding in our back holes, in our limbs, in every end of our bodies. You are driving them by fire. You are driving them. You are driving out every demon hiding in in our limbs, in our backbones. You are driving them out in the name of Jesus. By the fire of the Holy Ghost, the enemy has no place in our midst. Our bodies are the temple of God, our hearts are the joy. And therefore, God, we are not going to share your temple with you. We are not going to share your temple with you. We thank you, Jesus. We bless you, Lord. You are God.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be the name.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be the name.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jesus overcame.
Jesus overcame.
Hallelujah.
Jesus overcame.
Hallelujah. Asante kwa ajili ya mema ambayo umetuandalia. Asante kwa sababu ya ushindi wa msalaba. Asante kwa sababu ya kazi ya msalaba. Jina lako liimidiwe maana wewe ni Mungu mkuu. Wewe ni hodari wa vita. Haujawahi shindwa vitani. Wewe ni mshindi milele. Twasema asante. Asante kwa nguvu zako. Asante kwa ukuu wako. Asante kwa pendo lako Mungu wa Israeli. Asante kwa gurumo lako na radi. Unaponena Bwana, mbingu inatetemeka, dunia inatetemeka, milima inatikisika kwa sababu zinajua nguvu na uweza ulio ndani mwako. Wewe ndiwe Mungu uliyeumba mbingu na nchi. Umeinuliwa juu ya miungu yote. Ni nani aliye kama wewe? Asubuhi ya leo tumekuja mahali hapa. Tumekuja kukuabudu. Tumekuja kukuinua. Tumekuja kusema wewe ndiwe Mungu wetu. Wewe ni mshindi. Hakuna lisilowezekana mbele zako. Hii ni siku yetu Bwana. Siku ya kufunguliwa kwetu. Siku ya kukombolewa kwetu. Njoo ambazo zimefungwa Bwana, siku ya leo zinafunguliwa katika jina la Yesu. Uchawi unavunjwa. Kodi ya jeni ya ibilisi Bwana inateketea. Falsi za kishetani ambazo zimefungwa makaburini na kwenye miti na kwenye miamba na kwenye misitu na vichaka, siku ya leo zinateketea katika jina la Yesu. Ngome za shetani zinalipuliwa, maana wanao wamekutanika mahali hapa. Milango ya kuzimu haitalishinda kanisa lako. Tunasema wewe ni Bwana, tunakuinua, tunatambua nguvu zako, tunatambua uwepo wako, tunatambua kwamba Bwana tuko mahali hapa kwa sababu umependa. Asante Mungu wa Israeli. Tunasema asante kwa ushindi. Asante kwa ajili ya kila mmoja wetu. Na hata kwa ajili ya kila jamii aliyeko mahali hapa. Milango ya kuzimu inafungwa. Milango ya kuzimu inainama. Haishindi kanisa la Bwana. Maana hapa ni Mungu ambaye ni msingi wetu. Jehova katika utatu wako. Dhihirika katika utendaji. Watumishi wako wanaposimama mahali hapa. Take possession of them. Let them speak what comes from you. Take control over everything, oh God. Anoint our clapping. Anoint our dancing. Anoint our jumping. Anoint our singing. Anoint our smiling at each other. We rise against the spirit of hypocrisy. In the mighty name of Jesus, we decree there's no place in our midst. We are the children of God. The liar has no place in our midst. Father, you are the truth. Let your truth illuminate every area of our lives. We recover every blessing. Every blessing that the enemy has switched. Every blessing the enemy has switched, we recover it in the name of Jesus. Our stars, oh God, they must locate us. They must locate us today. They must locate us, Father. In the name of Jesus, we leave this place today having recovered everything the enemy has stolen. He must pay sevenfold in the mighty name of Jesus. We recover our children, our stolen children, physically and spiritually. We recover our families. We recover our stars. We recover our talents. We recover every gift that belongs to us. We recover our shining. We recover our shining. We recover our shining. We recover our shining. The enemy must pay sevenfold. He must pay. They must pay sevenfold. Them that have assembled against us, they will fall because of us. They are going to fall for our sake. Father, we thank you because that is your word. The expectations shall not be, and they shall not be accomplished. Whatever their purpose, it shall not come to pass. It shall not stand. It shall not come to pass, oh God, because you are our God and you have decreed. Your words are here and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Tunaomba Bwana chukua usukani utuongoze, kanende kati yetu Bwana. Tunafungua mioyo yetu Bwana, tunataka kupokea kutoka kwako. Utujaze nuru yako na makuu yako. Sehemu yote ya mioyo yetu, chemba kwa hata hiding any evil. Riba mpeye neema. Riha lanu ya lahani. Riba kenti riba baba yani. Thank you Jesus. Asante Baba yale sikomba raja ya kukomba zi kutombea kwa Baba. Katika china la Yesu tunaomba na Bwana. Amen.